This week on Snack Time with Miss B, we're making trail mix balls. Let me show you how. Remember to wash your hands well before you start preparing your snack. For today's recipe, you will need oats, peanuts, peanut butter, M&Ms, raisins, honey, and salt. You'll also need a mixing bowl, measuring cups, a plate, and a spoon. Let's get started. First, you'll need to pour 1 cup of oats into the bowl. Make sure it's full to the top. Using a cutting board and a knife, we will chop some peanuts. We need 1/4 cup to fill that. Just chop them roughly into smaller pieces. You can ask a grown-up for help. They're all chopped up and scoop them into your measuring cup. I have a little bit more than 1/4 cup, but that's okay. So once you measure it, dump it in. I'm going to put the rest of this in too. We want to add 1/4 cup of raisins as well. Add those to the bowl. Now we need 3/4 cup of peanut butter. So we'll put it in here and then we can melt it in the microwave. So use your spoon to scoop some peanut butter. You can use creamy peanut butter if you want or chunky, but we already have peanuts in there, so you don't really, this would be extra peanuts, which is fine. So squish it in. Till it's full, and then we'll put it in the bowl. That's 1/4. Two quarters or half. I will pop that in the microwave to melt it. You can microwave the peanut butter for about 20 to 30 seconds to start, and if it's not melted, give it a stir, put it back in just for 10 seconds at a time until it's melted enough. And once it's melted, it should be pretty runny like this. Make sure you're very careful when you take it out of the microwave. You should use oven mitts because the bowl will be very hot. So now we can add our peanut butter to our bowl. Scrape it all in there. Okay, now we're going to mix it all up. When you're mixing, it should start coming together like this. Some room here. Okay, so we need a tablespoon of honey. So you can use a measuring cup like this for a measuring spoon for a tablespoon. If you don't have a tablespoon, you can just use a big spoon like this to measure it. Something like that. It doesn't have to be exact. Drizzle it all in on top. And then you're going to mix that in. Pinch of salt. So you can shake a little bit of salt into your hand. Something like that. A few shakes, not too much. You don't want very much salt. Oopsies. Sprinkle that on. Okay. Give it one last mix. Okay, time for the fun part. Let's make a bit of room here. So, you need your plate and your bowl. Now you're going to use your hands. Make sure they're clean. You should have washed them before you started. And we are going to roll little balls and put them on the plate. Try not to let them touch each other. Leave a little bit of space in between. You can decide how big you want the balls. But probably it might not stay together very nicely, but you can play around with it, pack it together. You can decide if you want little balls or bigger ones and put them on. Let's make a bigger one. You might notice that the M&Ms are starting to fall apart, and that's just because the peanut butter is warm and it's melting the chocolate a little bit. There we have a big one and a little one. messy and hard to get them together, but you can. Gets a little easier if you make them a bit bigger. They're going to go in the fridge after this, so they will be firmer. You do a bigger scoop and you put it between your fingers, do sort of like this, give it a good squeeze, then I find it sticks a little better. They're a bit big, but it works. So keep going until you've emptied the bowl. If you run out of room on your plate, you can just put it on another plate. There we go. Now I'm going to put these in the fridge for about 30 minutes. After 30 minutes in the fridge, your trail mix balls are ready to eat. Enjoy!